Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, family. Welcome to the Mental House with me, your host, Khadija. The first thing I want to do is I want to send my condolences to the Mayweather family. Floyd Jr., Jeff, on the passing of Roger Mayweather. Roger had been through, a lot of people know that he had a lot of health issues in the last few years, and he had been deteriorating. I think he had like Alzheimer's or, you know, began to get punch drunk, which happens with a lot of pugilists, especially if they get hit a lot. As y'all know, my brother was the diamond belt, welterweight, golden glove champion here back in the 70s, and he fought during a time with Floyd Mayweather, Bruce Finch, and all those guys, Sugar Ray Leonard, Israel Acosta. I'm giving all these guys a shout out. Don Lee. Sometimes we wait until these people pass away before we give them their flowers, but I want to say that Roger Mayweather was very dedicated to his nephew. And I think when Floyd got himself in some trouble, because a lot of people don't know, them Mayweathers in Grand Rapids, right where the Barge family is from, they known for kicking ass. Grand Rapids is also, of course, in even one of these black towns, you go to churches, they're a very religious type of town, gangsters or religion. That's what I always say about certain cities in Michigan, like Saginaw, where New Birth is from. Shout out to Leslie and all y'all from New Birth, Yolanda, Allen. But what I'm trying to say is Michigan as a whole, Detroit, y'all already know, they speak for itself. But in Grand Rapids, the Mayweathers had really made a name for themselves before they even left Vegas. Some for nefarious behaviors. But I'm from the Midwest, and I'm very familiar with the Mayweathers. I'm more around Roger. I'm a little older than Roger. But my brother, again, I don't remember if he fought Floyd or if the fight didn't go. They were amateurs together. I know that. So my brother's name is Marlon. So they were, amateurs together. They just come from a fighting family. And like I said, Roger is the original Black Mamba. A lot of people, when they say Black Mamba, they think of Kobe Bryant. When I think of Black Mamba, I think of Roger Mayweather. And so, again, to his mother, I believe their mother's still living. I'm not really sure. All the sisters, all the family, the Mayweathers is a big bunch over there. And my condolences. Rest in power, Brother Roger. Job well done. You honed your craft. You did a good job with your nephew while his dad was away. And for that, you should be commended. Floyd had the talent, Floyd Jr., and he went to a world-class fighter. And put that family on the map even more. And not just for, they got fighting, but they fight legitimately. So, I want to give my condolences to the family, the Mayweathers, Floyd Jr., Floyd Sr., Jeff, and their sisters, and any of the rest of y'all out there, because I don't know y'all personally. The only ones I knew was the ones that I saw around the gym or when my brother went to train. So, again, my shout-out and my condolences. I'm giving a shout-out, I'm sorry, and my condolences is to the Mayweather family. I know this for Floyd Jr. This is very difficult. He just earlier in the week lost the mother of his children under, just really crazy circumstances. They found her in the car. There was no foul play or anything. No drugs or suicide. So, you know, and he has 3 children by her, if I'm not mistaken. So that's difficult, and I want to send my condolences. Like I said, prayers need to be circumventing around the Mayweather family right now because they're going through a crisis, like we all are. But I want to take the time out to acknowledge the greatness of the pugilist called the Mayweather family. Every family need a business, and they ran their business well. Congratulations, Mayweather. And rest in power, Roger. Rest in peace, Roger. And all your suffering now is a thing of the past. Be blessed, y'all. And I'll see you in the next video.